A very good morning to one and all present here. This is Deepak pursuing my BE Mechanical Engineering at CIT. So today we are going to see an interesting topic, which is nothing but tool wear and its tool life. So for every manufacturing process, for an every operation, for an every action, there must be a tool needed. So today, a subject which we are going to see in manufacturing process is the tool wear and the tool life. So guys, generally we know for every operation like such phasing, drilling, machining, and all kinds of manufacturing process and machining types, a tool is being a very essential part. So the tool's main consistence are its tool life and its tool wear. So a tool is considered as like a coin, which is nothing but has its two side, which is nothing but the tool wear and the tool life. So, and it has an brother relationship, or an it has its own relationship. Like when a tool life gets higher, the tool wear is low. When the tool wear is low, the tool life is being reduced. So these both combinations are being like vice versa. So let's go to the topic, which will be more interesting and more factful. So let's know about what is tool life. So tool life is nothing but the duration of actual cutting time after which the tool is no longer used. So in this line, we get to see about the duration of life. So for every piece of material, there must be a life. So as our tool, which produces more number of production rate and more number of productivity in manufacturing, has its own tool life. So generally, there are many ways of defining the tool life, and the common way of quantifying the end life of the limit on the maximal acceptable flank wear. So the main quantitying and the main measured thing is about the flank wear. So based upon the flank wear and the Carter wear, the tool life is being measured. So generally, due to these type of wears occur, the tool life is being reduced. The tool life is getting reduced because of some high forces or cutting speed, which is generally takes upon it. So when a high level of cutting force is acted upon it, it may be broken, or its tool life and its tool wear can be increased. So according to the force and the usage of the tool life is getting determined. So as per the duration of a particular tool over a work, the wear is occurred and the tool life slowly decreases. So let's go to the next slide. So let me explain you the failures which affects the tool life. So every life is being affected by an failures. So for a normal people, there are many kinds of failure affecting them. For our tool, the main which produces highly the manufacturing processes, like making an instance of products, the tool is the main thing. So for its life also, there must be a failure. So let me take you to that failures. So first is upon the fracture failure, which occurs due to the excessive cutting force on the tool point, which suddenly causes fail by a brittle factor, which is nothing but we can see it in the photo. So it is a drill bit which is affected due to this fracture failure, where the failure occurs depend on the force and the material. If the material is hardened enough and the drill bit is a bit softer, and not considering as a softer one, but it has an excessive force which should not be given to it. So after an excessive force, that couldn't be sustainable for the tool material and it gets failure. So a fracture, minimum level of fracture occurs while the excessive force, so that the failure occurs. So the next, temperature failure. As guys, so generally for our human beings also, overworking leads to an overheat up of mind. So according to this also, the overpressure and the over force acting upon it causes a major failure. The failure occurs when the cutting temperature is too high for the tool material. While cutting or using a high processed material over it by manufacturing, the tool points get to soften, so which is nothing but it tends to bendness, or it bends, or it can be said like it slowly blend. So which due to this high temperature, the cutting tool materials accessibility gets low, and it leads to plastic deformation and loses its sharp edge, which couldn't be usable for the further application or for the further operation which we can be done. So this temperature failure occurs while having a high force over the tool point and gets a temperature over it. So this gets a temperature failure. So the next one. So guys, next one, the gradual wear. Gradual is nothing but a wear which occurs slow and steady. The steady means it doesn't have an highly worn or a final tool failure, or which causes by actual acceleration over it. So while having a gradual wear, it's nothing but when a competitive force or a cutting force is being slowly induced in it. So generally, while manufacturing, a small amount of wear is being occurred in the sharp edges also. If we see by a microscope, which we see, we can observe it, how blend or how much wear has been occurred, but the edges will be sharp enough to cut for the proceedings, cause it will be highly strengthened and the carbon steel will be, and the tool material and the tool life will be highly procured, and it will be like a strong one. And this gradual wear occurs due to this flank wear and the Carter wear, which is nothing but the flank wear occurs on the edges of the tool, and the Carter wear occurs on the front portion of, I mean the top portion of the tool, where it majorly causes and it depletes the cutting edge. So these are the three failure guys which a tool occurs and makes the tool life low and the tool wear high. So to the next content, how the tool wear is being measured, which is nothing but by loss of tool material in a volume or weight, in which one lifetime this method is crude and is generally applicable for critical tools like grinding wheels. Like as such, we can see many grinding wheels being blended, which is the blended, which I mean is like the abrasiveness over it gets smoothened enough to grind the tool material. How long the abrasive material over it get not to blend, the productivity will be more. Like we can see, the generally the grinding wheels will be like in a rough manner, which has a rough surface over it. So when it gets to blend, could we make that grinding wheel to cut for an further productivity? No, definitely not. So it gets weird due to high pressure over it and high cutting force. Not in a cutting force also, but due to the high pressure over the tool. So this tool makes a high pressure over the work material, which is to be grinded. Due to its force and its pressure, it gets blended up. But this blending up doesn't get so easily. It will take a long time, but it will occur when a high force is applied. So we can measure these tool wears by using this optical microscope, which is fitted with a micrometer. So using this micrometer, we can measure how much level of tool wear is being occurred, and we can ensure that how much tool life is being guaranteed. So guaranteed is nothing but the tool life, which we can observe by through mathematical calculations. So a very common and effective method by using this optical microscope, the tool wear and its tool life is being calculated. And the another thing, it is nothing but the scanning electron microscope, which is generally used for high detailed study of both quality and quantity. So like a tool, the tool can be determined in various aspects, but after it, before a tool gets to equipped as it's a tool for and further operation or anything, the scientists or researchers, before producting it, they would be checking the quality and quantity of it. So how much it can produce and how quality it is to get produce the more number of production rate, which gives them in a high quality. So if a tool is no longer being used for after and 5 or 6 operation, its tool life is very low and its tool wear is highly overheat, because commonly a tool can perform its life based according to their method of working. So some tools may be highly worked and lubrications also may be done, but even though due to the high pressure, it gets too weird. So generally it's being observed as per the methods used and it is taken up into quantity into account also. So these are the method, guys, which are commonly used to measure the tool life by its wear. So we can measure the tool life by its wear also and by its hardenability also. So let's go to the next slide. So as I said, with the help of mathematical equation also, we can find it out. So this is the Taylor's tool life equation, where we can see by calculating the various cutting speed and tool life, based on the cutting life and tool life, the tools wear and productivity can be observed. Like as I described in the PPT, like if the tool life values for 3 wear curves are plotted on natural log on log graph of cutting speed versus the tool life, the resulting relationship is straight line expressed in the equation called the Taylor's tool life. As it says, the 3 wear curves, guys, the 3 wear curves, which is nothing but the lower to higher variability. Like the first stage is nothing but which slowly tends to lower the tool life, which is nothing but the cutting speed. After a high cutting speed, the gradual amount of tool life is being reduced and slowly the wear occurs. The tool life, when the tool life is reduced, we can directly observe the tool wearness over it. So these are the graph plots which gives the basic needy and the basic knowledge to us by showing the plotted graphs. So here, let me explain you the equation. The equation is nothing but Vtn equal to C, whereas V is nothing but the cutting speed and T, the tool life, which is to be observed by using this. And the C is nothing but the intercept on the speed axis at 1 minute of the tool life. Guys, you should believe that the every tool has its own life, and we can easily observe its tool life and its tool wear, guys. So while taking into action, see, as per I said, due to the flank wear occurs, it has an initial rapid wear at the side of an edge, which is in the break period. So after a rapid initial wear, it has an uniform wear rate, which I said as the workability of the tool, which is nothing but the productivity of its own, which is a steady state wear region where it has a lower amount of wearness. So in that way we can see about the tool wear, which is nothing but going in a steady state, which has an acute formation of life, which doesn't decreases easily, which I said that it has a productivity level having a constant wear, but doesn't affect the tool life for a certain period. So this tool life gets affected once it reaches the failure period, which I shown in this graph. So when accelerating wear rate, it is nothing but the cutting force which is given highly over the tool when used for an operation. So while having an accelerating wear rate over there, it lends to the failure region, which I told you before, the brittleness and the failures and the temperature failure and the gradual wear. So at this region, you can generally find out the failures of the tool life. So let's go to the tool wear. So hereby I explain you, you can see that I have been completely explaining the tool wear in the tool life itself. But a tool wear also is an important thing where it's separately apart from the tool life. So general tool wear occurs in any products. Like the tool wear is a gradual failure of cutting tools due to the regular operation. So the wear occurs due to the regular operation of a cutting tool. It occurs because of manufacturing the product regularly and its own compatibility. Like a tool can manufacture a single time about a percentage of from 50 to 60%, it generally occurs. Like a new tool can go along with the production rate as much as it can. But after the wear occurs, gradual failure will be start taking place, where it affects the tipped tools and the tool bits and the drill bits which is used by the machine tools. Like generally a human being using a tool which makes wear an usual thing, but the machine working tools are like, as per the feed it is given, the tool wear is being occurred. So the tool wear include plank wear, in which the portion of the tool in contact with the finished part of erodes. So guys, this sentence represents that the flank wear, in which the portion of the tool is in contact, as I said before, the flank wear which is nearly contacting with the manufacturing part, which is nothing but it has a contact with the finished parts of both the ends. Like the manufacturing product which is highly in contact with the parts of the end tips. So these are some types of tool wears which generally occurs in machining operation. The first one is the flank wear, and second one is the cutter wear, and third one is the notch wear, and third one is the edge wear. The edge wear is nothing but occurs in the edges side of the highly performing machining operation tools. So next slide. So guys, which is the most preferable wear over here? So for reducing the tool life, the wear occurs. So we should see that which of the wear is being useful and most preferable, like the temperature wear or the fracture wear or the gradual wear. So in this part we are going to take, and it is considered to be and best and most preferable wear, which is nothing but the gradual wear. So the gradual wear occurs because due to the fracture and temperature failures and the premature failures. So the temperature and the fracture failure also occurs in gradual wear, but in a slow stage. So the gradual wear is preferred because it's lead to the longest possible of the use of tool. So as I mentioned over here, the longest possible use of the tool, right, which I said before, like it takes the tool to a longest life. As per we are seeing, these two wears, these two failures which affects the tool life are the fracture failure and the temperature failure, which easily occurs due to the heat up of temperature, and the fracture failure which leads to a high cutting force. So these gradual wears are located on two positions of the tool, as we see that the cutter wear and the flank wear. So in this picture, we can see the actual rank angle and the nominal rank angle and the sharp tool's profile and the workpiece. While the tool gets into the contact, we can see the cutter wear and the flank wear. The cutter wear is directly in contact with the chip, which is nothing but the workpiece. So the flank wear is also in the contact. So these two will be reducing or being occurred in a slow rate of period. So in this gradual wear, we can be observed that the tool life is being increased. So the next slide. So how the tool wear occurs and measured? How can it be measured? So accordingly, two main types of tool wear can be distinguished, like cutter wear and the flank wear. We will use a single point tool to explain the tool wear and the mechanism that causes it. Mostly a single cutting point tool edge is being to be measured easily for the tool wear, because it doesn't have any inserts or tool profiles which is being added over it. So we can use a single point cutting tool which is being used to measure its overhead. So the cutter wear consists of a cavity in the rank face of the tool that forms and grows from the action of the chip sliding against the surface, which is nothing but when it gets to the cavity. The cutter wear consists of a cavity in the rack face angle, as we seen in the picture. The cutter wear is merely connected to the actual rank angle. So hereby it describes here that the cutter can be measured either by its depth or by its area. And let's know about the flank wear. The flank wear occurs on the flank or the relief face of the tool, which results from rubbing between the newly generated work surface and the flank face adjacent to the cutting edge. So guys, so the main point is the cutter wear gets contacted with the removed area, which is nothing but the chip. And the flank wear gets landed over the workpiece and gets started to affect from it the new surface, which is generated newly wear. We can see it here. So while removing a material, the cutter wear is being contact with the chip and the flank wear is get into the contact of the newly generated surface of the workpiece. So the flank wear is measured by the width of the wear band. This wear band is sometimes called the flank wear band. So guys, here we can see the cutter wear. So this is the tool of an tool material, which we can see the cutter wear. So in this, as I said in before, this cutter wear occurs and gets contacted between the tool and the removal of the tool, which is nothing but the chip. So as we see in this part, the cutter wear is being induced over here, and which the pictures can be seen over here, which lends to a cutter wear and makes it to get a gradual amount of reduction in its tool life. So the flank wear occurs over the tip, which I said that it is directly connected or contact with the newly generated surface, as per we seen in the first slide over it. So guys, how do you think that this minute pictures can be taken of a tool? So these are the pictures of wear which is viewed and observed by using the tool maker's microscope. So guys, generally a point to be noted, which is nothing but every tool wear can be measured using this tool maker's microscope. So by viewing it, we can observe the two, we can calculate the two life as per its wear and as per its amount of area which is being used over it. So the next slide. So guys, which are the mechanisms causes this tool wear? What are the mechanisms which generally causes this tool wear? So the first is nothing but the abrasion. This is a mechanical wearing action caused by the hard particles in the work material grooving and removing small portions of the tool. It occurs in both flank and quarter wear. It's a main cause of flank wear. So this abrasion mechanism which occurs on both the flank wear and the quarter wear. So generally, while removing a small portions of the tool, this abrasion induces and makes the tool wear highly affected, and highly affected in the sense of it lends to high wearness. So next is the adhesion. When two metals are forced into contact under high pressure and temperature, adhesion or welding occur between them. Small particles of the tool are broken away from the surface, resulting in arcuation of the surface. Whereas guys, this is nothing but this adhesion happens like a welding process. Like sometimes we can notice that some of the chip materials is being attached to the tool particle. I mean the tool, like it tends to get welded while a high temperature and high pressure occurs over there. So while removing some small particles, the tool and the chip which is broken away is being resulting in the attraction of the surface. So the next two mechanisms which we are going to see is the diffusion, guys. This is a process in which an exchange of atom takes place across a close contact of boundary between two materials. In the case of tool wear, diffusion occurs at the tool chip boundary, causing the tool surface diffusion is believed to be a normal principle of mechanism of a quarter wear. As we see, this diffusion is mainly occurred in the quarter wear, which the quarter wear we used to see, which happens on the top of the tool, which is nothing but having a good contact with the chip formations and which is being removed. So this diffusion occurs over there in the exchange of atoms, which has a close contact boundary between the two metals, which is the two materials, which is nothing but the removal and the tool. So next, using this chemical reaction, the high temperature and clean surface of the tool chip, interference in machining at high speeds can result in chemical reaction, in particular oxidation on the rack face of the tool, the oxidation layer being softer than the parent tool material and it shredded away. So guys, this generally we can see while machining and products, we can see the tool getting veered up. So as far we are seeing it, the tools are getting veered due to the high pressure and high temperatures. So in this chemical reaction, it gets veered due to the high temperature and of clean surface, with the clean surface has its chemical oxidation, which affects and which is correlated to the wear process. So guys, the main note is about most of the tool wear mechanisms are accelerated at high cutting speed and temperature. This diffusion and chemical reaction are especially sensitive to elevated temperature, which is nothing but open to atmosphere, the elevation. So these kind of mechanisms occurring in the tool wear are in general. So while using a better tool, we need to see its tool life in its tool wear condition. If doesn't matches perfectly, we couldn't be able to attain a proper productivity of an object. So as I said, the coin faces, like it has both the sides, like the coin is nothing but the tool, and which has its tool via one side and the tool life with having an same compatibility. So thank you for giving me an wonderful opportunity to explain this topic in a brief manner. So thank you, sir.